Student, so we were discussing this chapter solid, liquid and gases, and we have learned many things. Okay, first we have learned that solid, liquid and gases are different in some properties. Okay, what we have learned, like that this is the example of solid and the example of liquid is water, and then example of gas is steam. You can find there is a difference that solid have definite shape and volume. Liquid only have definite volume, it doesn't have definite shape. And gases neither have definite volume nor have definite shape. That we have learned, okay? And then we have learned the different process also: evaporation, melting, condensation, freezing. These processes we have learned. Today we are going to learn that there is a difference between solid, liquid and gases, but there is some similarities also. What are the similarities? Because all these are the matter, these are the different kinds or different forms of matter. Okay, water can exist in all three forms. Solid form of water is ice. Liquid form of water is water what we are drinking, and gaseous form of water is water vapor or steam, we can say. Okay, so these are the different form of water. Means water is same, that is matter. So now children, this solid, liquid and gases all are matter, and the definition of the matter is anything that have weight and occupy space is called matter. So from first what it is said, that anything that have weight. Okay, so because the solid, liquid and gases all are matter, so they all have weight. All the matter, whether it is solid, liquid or gas, has weight. Okay, you can find by yourself also. For that, what you have to do, only you take one balance here, any type of balance you can use if it is available at home. Okay, otherwise you can make by yourself only. You make one stick like this, okay, and make one holder, one basket this side of the stick and one basket this side of the stick. Okay, like that you tie one basket this side, you can tie one basket of same size and one basket this side, okay, of the stick. Then what you will do, you will put some solid object in one of the basket. Okay, here I have put potato, and this side you keep empty only, because you had made this balance at home only, you don't have any weight. Otherwise we are using weight. You can see in the market also, when you are going to buy potato, they are putting 1 kg, 2 kg weight this side, and then he is measuring. Now he is measuring the weight of the object. So here we are not putting the weight, simply only we have to find that matter has weight or not. So we are putting potato this side. When you will put any solid object in a one side of the basket, you will see that it will goes down and this will goes up. Otherwise it was like this only, now it was balanced. Starting it was balanced only, both the basket, when we have not put anything, both the basket was balanced only. Okay, as we have put the solid object here, this side will goes down and this will go up. Okay, why? Because this is heavy than this side, because this side is empty and this side one solid object, and this is heavy. It is heavy means by this we can see that this object is having weight. Due to weight only it is coming down. Okay, this side of balance is coming down due to weight only. So from this we can find that the solid object is having weight. Now same experiment we can do with the liquid object. In one side of the balance, we will put one empty glass. Okay, nothing is filling it. Means nothing here is there, but here I am saying it is empty. Okay, no liquid is there. And another side of the bell is we will put one glass with some water in it. Okay, then you will find that the side of the bell will goes down in which there is a water. Okay, side of the bell will go down in which side there is a glass with water. This means this is heavy tank, this one, this is heavy. We know now which is going down, that is heavy, and which is going up, that is light. Okay, this is also heavy and this is light. So it is going down means the glass with water is heavy than the glass without water. So from this also we can find that the water means liquid has weight. Now same type of experiment we will do with the gas. Here what we will do, we will tie the balloon in the both side of the balance. One side of the balance there is a balloon which is not filled, okay, which has not filled with any gas, and another side we are tying the balloon which we have filled. Okay, so you will find that the balloon which is filled with gas is heavy than the balloon which is not filled with gas, that is lightweight. So means from here we can find that gas has weight. So you can perform this activity at home also. I have shown you with the help of one string you will stick, okay, and you can perform this activity and you will find that all the matter has weight, whether it is solid form, liquid form or gas form, all are matter only. So all has weight. This is the common property of solid, liquid and gas. If someone will ask what is similarity between solid, liquid and gas, we can say that all has weight and all occupy space. Second property is that all occupy space, and that we will discuss tomorrow. Okay, today we have discussed matter has weight, and tomorrow we will discuss matter occupies spaces. Okay, so what we have learned till now, children, we have learned that all substance and object around us can be solid, liquid and gaseous form, and solid, the three form of water means the solid form of water is ice, the liquid form of water is water what we are drinking, that normal water, and gaseous form of water is water vapor or steam. Okay, so there is a they are dissimilar, this solid form, liquid form and gaseous form. Solid is rigid, okay, solid has definite shape and volume, liquid can flow, okay, and it doesn't have definite shape, only it has fixed volume. Gaseous, it doesn't have definite shape, it doesn't have fixed volume, and it can also flow like a liquid. Okay, so these are the difference between them. Now the similarity between all three are that they all has weight, whether it is solid, liquid and gases, all has weight. And second similarity that they all occupy space, that we will learn tomorrow. Okay, so they all occupy space means they are having volume. Okay, it is not fixed in gas but it is fixed in solid and liquid. Okay, they all occupy volume. And we have performed one activity here to show that matter has weight, in which we have used the balance, and by putting different objects in a one side of the balance, we find that solid also has weight, liquid also has weight, and gas also has weight. So thank you children, have a nice day.